Hello friends, in this video we will learn what is meant by finite state machine. Let us begin. So finite state machine is a computational model that can be used to simulate sequential logic circuit. So now we will see the purpose of finite state machine. So as I said, finite state machine is a computational model that can be used to simulate a sequential logic circuit. So basically, this finite state machine is a computational model and basically it is used to simulate a sequential logic circuit. Also, this FSM, that is finite state machine, it is used to model a problem in many fields. So just to explain you what is finite state machine, it is just a digital machine. It is simulated using a computational model using finite states. I repeat, it is represented using finite states. Now, just to give you a real-time example, by understanding which it would be quite clear what is exactly meant by finite state machine and how it works. So we'll take an example of automatic teller machine, that is what we called as popularly ATM. So now I'll explain you ATM, that is automatic teller machine, as FSM, that is finite state machine. Basically, finite state machine is represented using state diagrams. I'm sure you must have seen the previous lectures where we have studied sequential logic circuits, that is synchronous counter as well as asynchronous counter. There we have already drawn those state diagrams. So now you will see state diagrams here. Now consider ATM machine. It works in sequence. For example, when you enter into ATM machine, the machine is already in a reset state or a power on state where it asks you to enter the valid debit card. So for example, when you enter into ATM machine, consider that machine is in a reset state called as S0 and it is waiting for you to insert a debit card. Now there are two possibilities, whether you enter a valid debit card or you enter invalid debit card. For example, if you have entered or you have swiped a valid card, then only, let's say it goes to another state called as S1 state, and in S1 state it is asking you to enter the type of account, whether you have a current account or a saving account, right? Now it is coming in S1 state provided that you have entered or you have swiped a valid debit card. What if somebody had swiped invalid one? Then it is not going to allow to go in S1 state. So for invalid state or for invalid card, it is going to remain in S0 state only, right? So considering now you have already entered into S1 state and now you have, let's say, selected, you have saving type of account. So for saving type of account, it is now moved to S2 state. Or for current account, it might enter into another state called as S3 state. So I consider that my account is a saving account. So I consider myself in S2 state. In S2 state, now it is asking you to enter a PIN number, that is ATM PIN number, which is generally 4-bit in size or 4-digit in size. So now in S2 state, it is asking you to give you a valid PIN number. So if the valid PIN number is entered, so let us call this state as S4 state. So if you have entered a valid PIN number, you go to S4 state. Suppose if somebody goes for invalid PIN number, then it will go to the reset state. So for invalid PIN number, you are forced to go in S0 state and again you have to get your card out of the machine and again you have to insert, and again you have to follow the whole sequence, right? For example, now you have entered a valid pin number, then it is going to get into another state called as S5 state. Let's say in S5 state, it is asking you to enter the amount. Is that right? So in S5 state, it is asking you for an amount to enter. Now, the user enters the amount. That amount has to be a valid amount. What is meant by valid amount? That amount has to be a multiple of hundreds. Suppose if you enter amount as 50 or 25, then such amount are considered to be invalid amount. Or invalid amount can be taken as an amount that somebody has entered the amount, that amount should be also there. Let's say the amount that you have entered, that must be present in your saving account, right? I mean, amount shouldn't exceed the limit that is available in your account also. So for invalid amount, again, you are forced to get into S0. Is that right? Suppose you have entered valid amount. A valid amount is an amount which is multiple of 100 as well as available in your account. Then only you go to S6 state. So in S6 state, what is going to happen is you're going to get your all amount, as well as now after getting your amount, you're going to get your card back. And once you get your card as well as amount back, then automatically it gets into S0 state. Is that right? So once all the procedure is over, it is getting back to S0 state. So now it is waiting for another person to come, or it might happen that now you want to go for another transaction, you can again start with S0 state. So this is how the finite state machine is working. So before designing any digital machine or any sequential logic circuit, engineers basically draw this state diagram, because if the state diagram is not clear, then how one can actually design a sequential logic circuit? If all these sequences are fixed, if we know that which state is going to come after which state, then only it is possible to design a particular digital machine. So it is very important that you should know how to design a finite state machine. Now, let us talk about a gate point of view. We are not actually going to design finite state machines, but now from gate point of view, it is essential to understand a sequence detector, which is a special type of a finite state machine. So what is important from gate point of view is to study a sequence detector. So what is meant by sequence detector? That you will be applying some binary input stream here, let's say 01001000101110. This type of, let's say, binary sequence I'm going to apply to a particular machine. That machine is now known as a sequence detector, which has output, let's say, as Y. Let us assume input as X. Of course, it is a sequential logic circuit, so it will have a clock input also. So it has two inputs. One is a clock input, the another input is X, where binary input stream is applied. And this machine is known as a sequence detector. So I'm writing in a short, that is SD, stands for sequence detector. So if a particular sequence is detected by this machine, output goes high. Output means it is Y. Output goes high only when a particular sequence is detected, only when a particular binary sequence is detected by the machine, then only output Y goes high, and after that it automatically becomes zero. For example, I can design this machine for detecting binary sequences such as 1010 or 010 or 1011, etc. So in next video, we will actually see how these sequence detectors are designed. In fact, we don't have to design a circuit. We have to only design up to a state diagram. So gate point of view, only that thing is important, that we don't have to really design a machine, but we have to design only up to a state diagram. So now we will be designing sequence detector so as to detect binary sequences such as 1010 or 010 or 1011, or you can assume your own example. If these binary sequences are detected by this machine, a sequence detector, then only output goes high. After that, it automatically goes to zero. In sequence detector, we are going to study two types, that is overlapping sequence detector and the other type is non-overlapping sequence detector. So the two categories that we are going to study, that is overlapping sequence detector and non-overlapping sequence detector. So definitely understand what is meant by overlapping sequence detector and non-overlapping sequence detector if you see next two video lectures also. Thank you.